move the needle much.
All right, Nisha, thank you so much for those details. Now, moving on, the Reserve Bank of India on Thursday issued a notification barring payment system operators from issuing any new proprietary QR codes. And they've also asked those players who are currently using proprietary QR codes to shift to the interoperable QR codes, which is the UPI QR or the Bharat QR by March 2022. Now, just to break this down, QR codes are, of course, the quick response codes that you see, the black square stickers that you see, you know, when you make payments at your neighborhood stores. And what RBI is really asking is that they should not be closed loop systems. Any customer should be able to use any app to make a payment to a merchant through the QR code. They want it interoperable. Now, in another notification yesterday, the RBI has also called for applications to form a self-regulatory organization for the payment sector. To discuss these developments, we have with us Vishwas Patel, Chairman of the Payments Council of India. Vishwas, welcome on the show and season's greetings. Firstly, if you can just talk about the QR code and what the impact really will be on players. You know, have most players in the system actually moved to interoperable QR codes already over the last few years, or are there a sizable number of players who will now have to shift?
Hi, Mukda. Yes, we have, I think, as RBI has rightly done, making all QR codes interoperable. What it will essentially mean is that the power is not concentrated in a few players like what we see in China today, right? China State Council's Anti-Monopoly Commission is now investigating Alipay and WeChat, right? Today, because of their proprietary QR code, they are just shifting money left pocket, right pocket within their systems. And today, Alipay with 55% market share in China and WeChat at 39% of the overall $8 trillion Chinese market. So they are monopolized by using their closed proprietary QR codes. Essentially, what it means is that if you go on a seller's or a shop's checkout counter, you'll see multiple QR code of Alipay, this pay. We were seeing the same thing in India. There were at least 6 to 7 different QR codes on every retail counter. Right. So we did.
My question to you is whether there are a lot of players who have been using proprietary QR codes who will now have to shift to interoperable.
Yes, I think the draft report was already placed, and what we see is that in September of 2019, PhonePe already moved to interoperability putting up interoperable codes. Right. And even Paytm from January of this year has already started installing interoperable code. Right. So almost, I believe Paytm says that almost a crore counters already have interoperable codes.
Right. So some of the big players have moved. Now, coming to the second notification by the RBI, they're calling, to set up a self-regulatory organization. What do you make of this? And will PCI, the Payment Council of India, also apply to, join this self-regulatory organization?
Yes, definitely. In fact, informally, we've already been working with RBI on such kind of an SRO, because every small rules, regulations, bylaws between the payment ecosystem players need not come by a clarification or a notification from RBI, right? It's better to have that self-regulatory organization within the payment system guys itself, who can evolve by having that best practices and other processes, so that digital economy can grow.
Right.
The consumers can have a very safe experience, a clear kind of a risk management, risk protection, as well as different mechanism and other things.
So is PCI going to apply?
Yes, we are going to apply. And as I said, we are already informally working with RBI on such kind of organization.
Okay.
We needed that regulatory, kind of a backing.
Okay.
And I think this SRO just solves that. I think it's a very bold, innovative, and a very good step by RBI.
Okay. All right, Vishwas. Lastly, I have to ask you about this whole Google Play Store billing issue that's really been raging in the startup ecosystem. The Payment Council of India was also part of these discussions with, the IMAI and the government. Have you raised this issue also with regulators like RBI and NPCI? Because, you've cited the problem and you say that Google is not authorized to force merchants to go through their billing system. What are the steps that you've taken?
Yes, I think we are talking to everybody and anybody, be it in the government or regulatory or RBI, who are willing to listen to us. Because I think from our country's independence point of view, we can't have one operating system provider dominating and you know, sort of dictating terms to merchants to use their own proprietary billing and payment system versus the RBI authorized payment systems. So say if I were a merchant, if I were an education merchant or anything, right now Google forces them. Right now it's delayed for another 6 months till February of next year, till it comes in place. But what it means is that if a education merchant is using, say, a CC Avenue payment gateway for its own website for collections, plus in the app, be it for Android or iOS, right? Android says that no, you cannot use an RBI authorized payment gateway like CC Avenue. They have to compulsory use the Google Play Store for education, for fitness, for gaming, okay. Lot more categories. So it entails,
okay.
And this means that it's a dictate that you have to pay 30% MDR part of that.
All right. Listing. Okay, Vishwas, thank you so much for sharing those details with us. Thank you so much again for joining us on Startup Street. Now, moving on, a do-it-yourself